Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the weekly show with Aditya, India's number one podcast, with India's number one host, Aditya. Coming to you live every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. In association with Dusra.net, the number one website in sports, education, and entertainment. This is your host, Aditya, the best in the world, and I welcome you to episode 51 on the 29th of March 2019, and the time by the studio clock is 10:40 a.m. The Ashwin controversy just seems to be lingering around like a bad infection, and it seems that everybody has caught up to this contagious issue. Once again, what he did, that is running out a batsman, is subjective. It is not the question of being right or wrong or moral or ethical. Should we now suspend him for a year like we did with Warner and Smith? In that situation, what happened exactly a year ago? It was done by misleading the officials on the field, but here the official on the field took that decision, and yet we are talking about it again and again. It's time to close this chapter, and a chapter which has been haunting Warner and Smith for the past 1 year. These two individuals have already been given the treatment like two criminals on parole. We keep deluding ourselves by calling cricket a gentleman's game, but that is, as I said, a big delusion. Unlike the officials in hockey and football, in cricket, the umpires do not have full authority on the field. You can read more about this in my book, The Fifth Umpire, which is available on Amazon.com. That is Amazon.com. The hard copy will be available on Amazon.in. Let's agree that this T20 domestic competition is nothing more than entertainment and extra money for the players and the officials involved, with players moving on from one team to another as they choose and please, or as the management of the domestic team decide. There is no loyalty to one team, and money is the only pull factor which has the players rushing towards such tournaments instead of resting and recuperating for much bigger prize. Josh Butler plays for Sydney Thunders in the Australian T20 domestic competition, and now he is playing for Royal Challengers Rajasthan. Yuvraj is another player who has shifted around from one team to the other. He has played for Pune, that is the Pune Warriors India, when it was in focus. Then he shifted to Bangalore. From Bangalore, he went to Punjab, then Hyderabad Knight Riders. Then he gets another lifeline while he has been selected for the Bombay team, as most pseudo-critics presume that his career is now over. Even the fact that if international players are playing together just before the World Cup, we might see players analyzing strength and weaknesses of each other, but even that is a conjecture. If we want this tournament to be remembered, then we have to do away with a few bad practices, such as the two strategic timeouts, two of 2.5 minutes each, plus an ad break of 45 seconds after every over and nearly a minute after every time a wicket falls. My suggestion is that one strategic timeout of 3 minutes is enough, and then the break time between every over or every time the wicket falls should not be more than 30 seconds. The start time of 8 p.m. also needs to be re-evaluated. The ideal time would be 6:30 p.m. Though the logic presented for a 8 p.m. start is that most offices shut at 6 p.m. and it will take almost 2 hours for individuals to enter the ground. Well, this reasoning doesn't cut ice with me, and the best time is 6:30 p.m. so that we can finish maximum by 10 p.m. instead of dragging the match till 12 a.m. These strategic timeouts and ad breaks will only suffice if the teams finish one innings between 80 to 90 minutes. Otherwise, they will drag it to 2 hours. Or a decision needs to be made that if the teams finish one innings, especially the team bowling first finishes their innings taking more than 90 minutes, then looking at the time available and how much time has been taken to finish the first innings, the team chasing should have a reduction in the number of overs. This kind of a practice will be a deterrent for teams to finish their innings in 90 minutes or even 95 minutes and not waste time unnecessarily. We can also have a provision that if a lot of time is being taken to complete 20 overs, then at the end of 90 minutes, for example, if 18 overs have been completed, then we should finish the innings at that. This will have everyone in check, from advertisers to broadcasters to players to officials, to not to waste any time with frivolous advertisements. And injury time or drinks time also needs to be taken into consideration. And this should not be only for this domestic competition, but for all international matches. Irrespective of 20 overs, 50 overs, 5 days, red ball, green ball, blue ball, pink ball. Teams are allowed only 15 seconds to decide whether they should take the review or not. Then the third umpire should also be cognizant of the time taken to come to a final decision. With the World Cup looming in one corner, there is an effort to make this tournament relevant. Knowing that the major international players who are due to participate in the World Cup will be pulled out of the tournament, teams are trying to make each player available as much as possible. For the first time in over a dozen years, the Indian Cricket Board and the T20 domestic teams will have no power whether the players should go back to their respective countries to prepare for the World Cup, and their bullying tactics will be negated as the International Cricket Council's authority will take over. Teams will try to make sure that those players who are retired or most likely discarded from their respective board's viewpoint will be given more chances as we go deep into the tournament, which means that someone like A.V. de Villiers, Suresh Raina, Yuvraj Singh will play their full quota of matches, as de Villiers is now retired while Yuvraj and Raina are being seen as discarded materials. Though like the greats of the game, Yuvraj is the only Indian player who has played the maximum number of years after Tendulkar. That is, Tendulkar played for 24 years and Yuvraj has nearly done it for 2 decades. So whatever be the juvenile excuses of age, form and fitness, Yuvraj deserves his opportunity to play his final World Cup tournament. Having seen both the Australian T20 domestic competition and the Indian T20 domestic competition, I have come to the conclusion that the Australian version is more professional in terms of playing the sport, while the Indian version is more reliant on everything else but the players in the middle and the sport as a whole. The hockey team under the radar has reached the final of the Sultan Azlan Shah Cup, trying to make sure that the horrors of the 2018 World Cup are buried for once and all. A fresh year, fresh tournament and new faces had made sure that we now move on to greater heights and look at the 2020 Olympics and the 2022 World Cup as the next big targets. It also means that whatever be the result, a silver medal is guaranteed, and there is nothing more pleasing than getting a silver medal, or even if we can win this tournament, a gold medal will add to the tally and make one feel the faith in hockey once again. News sources. What are my news sources? Well, there is a research that Indians prefer quote unquote social media as a prominent news source. Well, I tend to disagree with this group in terms of reliability, accountability. Only print media and electronic media come close to as prominent and proficient news sources. While social media, well, even the term social media is misleading. All they do is just copy and paste prominent news media websites, and we presume that they have their own news sources. There is nothing traditional or ancient about using newspapers, magazines, or electronic media as news sources. They are as modern as any other element on this planet. Twitter, Facebook, and other similar sites are for those who cite lack of time as a reason not to go for electronic and print media. Since it takes a considerable amount of patience and brain power to read and sift through newspapers, it is not something that is made for those who do not have the time and patience to read through each and every word. They rather rely on 280 words on Twitter by some unreliable source to take it as a source of decent and important piece of information. So if an individual does not use these gossip sites as the source of information, or as a source of, and I quote, to influence and to be influenced, does not make them a dinosaur or technologically deficient. Rather, it makes them even more mature, as they know what information is true and what is just a piece of gossip and unreliable source. So let me tell you, newspaper in their physical and for some in their digital form are not going anywhere. Nor is there any form of competition between print, electronic and pseudo media. If you do not tweet or put something on Facebook or even Instagram, it does not make you ancient. Rather, it makes you sane. So if you want to be a part of my show, please send your valuable suggestions and send your recordings on topics ranging from sports, education and entertainment on the email ID adityathewriter@gmail.com. That is adityathewriter@gmail.com. Thank you for listening to this episode. Please like and subscribe to my Facebook page and YouTube channel, and stay tuned for the next episode.